this is going to be a bit risky. We're very nervous.
We haven't been this nervous since Live Aid, have we?
Can I go make me bed and I'll be with you?
The acoustic set tonight is going to be different, nerve-wracking. I think a lot of people are fascinated to see and hear this show. So I just hope we can deliver it properly.
The whole thing is different, the dynamic of an electric guitar. You can thrash it somewhat. With these, particularly as we get on, we will start hitting the thing, and they don't respond very well. So you've got to try and stroke it. You know what I mean, like? Stroke it a little bit.
That's the fact, I find, you've got to reach across the body, like that, you know, and you're kind of playing and trying to lay...
Excuse me, I'm enjoying this.
I thought, well, you were looking good.
It's been a while.
The more I'm talking about it now, I'm getting nervous now, because time is pushing on. We're going to be on there in... Another opening, another show, and here at the Roundhouse, away we go. Years, 45 years, we've never done a show sitting down. We've wanted to, but we've never have. And I tell you what, it's a really weird phenomena because when you sit down, you sit there all day and play this, go right through the set, and then you can't get up. You can't get up again. It's going to be quite funny walking off tonight. I should get some footage of that.
We should be carrying
hobbling off. It's another unknown territory for us because there's, I think, what, 15, 16 people on stage? It's all a bit unknown. Plus the fact, I think your bottle twitches a little bit in as much as if you go wrong, if you forget a bit, it high levels of concentration it takes because the strings are reading it all. So they march on, right? If you miss a cue or miss a verse, they've gone. Catch those strings up. Where are we?
You're doing it again. You're doing it again.
It's terrible.
It sounds so nice. I want your proposing. I just once or twice. Oh, when I'm disclosing. Oh, when I'm disclosing. How I'm really, really feeling. I watch your proposing. The other night. Oh, as I was leaving. I looked down the light. Oh, when I'm believing. Oh, when I'm believing. And I finally believe.
You may have noticed there's some extra people on stage with us. We've got the posh people on the left that read everything. They're real musicians. We've got a guy here that blows air through a thing and play. I don't know what he's doing. He's sitting there. And another bloke in the corner beats hell out of stuff, so I don't know what he's doing either. They're all with us, and it should be a good night, I hope. Oh, God almighty. And this next song, I say song, I can't call our thing songs, I've told you that before, but there we are. It's a bit high, so if I strain a little, you know, you'll help, I'm sure. This is a song called Down Down.
In Matchstick Men, because
you were in the
I was married, got married very young.
And you were in the
I was in the and I was in the lounge for a while. The wife had gone out with her mother,
yes,
and I started to write this thing, and then they came back, so I had to sit, and people may remember the old prefabs, and I sat in the loo and tried to finish it sitting in the loo like that, and that's...
How many hits did they have in the old prefabs?
They had a few, the old prefabs.
Well, I have to say, really, about Matchstick Men, the melody is just fantastic. And it's just, it's a class song. It really is great. The lyric is great. Peeking through, not peeping, peeking, you know? And I just picked up on that the other day, first time I ever heard it. Peeking, peeping through my window. We only recorded it 58 years ago, whatever it was, and I just realised. But it's a great song, and particularly done acoustically with the strings and everything, it brings the beauty out in it, and it's been sort of laying there. We've done this little version in 68, which was a massive hit, and it's laying there wanting all this orchestration on it. It's beautiful.
Oh, it's alright if they sound just like other songs. My guitar's strumming along just the same it would with the songs underlined with my name. Sing.
if you stay right on to the end. If my songs haven't been just the boy you never met, then I hope you may come back for more. Sing. Songs that I think sound so strange, writing words that I feel I should change. Well, it's alright if they sound just like other songs. My guitar strums along just the same. It's the songs of the line with my name. Na 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 na.
I was trying to write a song like Jimi Hendrix's Hey Joe, which is how we wrote Matchstick Men. And then we quickly realised we were becoming unfashionable and losing it.
It was never going to last with the frilly shirts and what we were dressed in to do that early Top of the Pops, but we had our foot in the door. We thought, well, we were sick of looking like we looked and the audiences were diminishing. I mean, you know, there were a few screaming girls to start with, and that's what I'd always dreamed of, to be up on stage in front of screaming girls. And when it got down to three, do you remember going to Margate?
Oh, I do.
Three girls going,
yeah.
And we thought, it's time to change something here.
So myself, I'm really nothing.
Oh, my bum's getting warm. I've just still got to check the list. Doesn't matter what we do, I still have to check the list. This is the song that was written by Rick and Andrew, I think. I can't remember now. And it's never been one of my faves. I don't know why, but... No, don't get like just that. I love playing the thing. I never just sort of... However, this time round, it's got me going. There's something about it. That shut you up, didn't it?
It's a song he doesn't like.
This is called Don't Drive My Car.
So long since I sang songs to you.
I really enjoyed making the record, more than I've done any record, I think, and I don't really know why. It was every day going in, was it was like opening up a flower. It was like it was more beauty each day. And then came the freaking rehearsals. And that's, for the first couple of weeks or so, that was OK. And then as we got closer and closer, we're both of us getting really edgy. And the weird thing is, at the end of rehearsals, normally you go home, you go home.
I don't know it.
This time, you get in a car and you were kind of zonked. And I don't, perhaps it's because we're thick, but we did, the amount of focus, it was just ridiculous. And I still can't, I still think this ain't going to go wrong.
And the worst thing in the world is when you go to sleep thinking, oh, I'm going to do it all again tomorrow, I'll be fine. When you go to sleep, if you can get to sleep, because if you get this rehearsal in your head and get those songs going, where does it go? Yeah. You have to turn the light on, pick the guitar up and go, oh, right, I'll go out to sleep now.
hang up your shoes, just kick out the blues and rock till you drop tonight. All we do depends upon you, so rock till you drop tonight. We hit all the high spots, the star-studded bills and those mirror balls. Half of the time we were playing a game, half of the time I could hardly remember my name. Stay with us now and hang in somehow and rock till you drop tonight. Rock till you drop tonight. We hit all the high spots, the star-studded bills and those mirror balls. Half of the time we were playing a game, half of the time I could hardly remember my name. So stay with us now somehow and run till you drop tonight. All we do depends upon you, so rock till you drop tonight. Rock till you drop tonight. Rock till you drop tonight.
I just remember Andrew Bowne turning up at my house one day, and we went into the studio and did what we normally do, and I know he'd come down with this, da-da-da-da-da, whatever you want. I think, yeah, great, OK. So we just went in and just wrote it from there. But we had a wonderful day, like we always did in those days. We were out of our trees.
I was going to say, out of your trees.
Yeah, well, out of our trees, and enjoyed every minute of it. And that, at the end of the day, we had whatever you want. perpetuate an old story. We were walking home one night, weren't we, from somewhere, and saying, you know, if we can get 5 years out of this, we'd had Matchstick Men, you know, and we thought, you know, been on top of the pops.
Own house paid for,
yeah.
Car paid for, yeah. 50 grand in the bank. What else would you
live
need?
Live forever.
Mm. The whole industry was different then. Nobody was going to last. The older generation of the time were very much like, I mean, I remember Rick's dad saying, we were in the chart with Paper Plane and the Power Driver album, and his dad still could not see that this might be a good living, and said to him, if you get your hair cut, I'll get you a job with me. And he was going, Dad, and just couldn't see it. So that generation could not see that this was going to happen, but then nor could we. I mean, the fact that Jagger and our uncles are out there older than us at 7, 5, and we're pushing 51, you're 52.
Well, the thing about us is, you see, right from the start, we've always known that we're good. We've always believed that. Whether we actually are or not.
That's a good point.
I actually think we are. But a lot of people would disagree with me, a lot of other people would agree with me. But I know that we're a kin good band.
I think I've got pretty much everything.
Thanks,
I need.
Goodbye.
Bye. Thank you.
Till you scratch the writing.